Welcome back, YouTube. A couple things to talk about today. The big topic is why you are not losing those last 10 pounds. We got five reasons for you that we're gonna go over today. Before we even do that, we gotta talk about our beer, of course. We have our Spotted Cow getting ready for the CrossFit Games in Madison, Wisconsin. This is a Wisconsin native. If you've never had a Spotted Cow, you are missing out. It's good stuff.
You guys are also gonna see a little updated intro of Joe and I. That's like a half of a day of shooting. It took a while.
There was hours of content.
Yeah, hours of content that one of the guys at the gym here really did an awesome job of putting together for us. So you're going to see a little intro. Let us know what you guys think about it in the comments. That's going to be on every video you see. And yeah, it's pretty good. Oh. All right, so before we get into the top five reasons why you are not losing those last 10 pounds, we should probably first discuss what they are.
Yeah. What you talking about, Will?
And for who they are, because they're not going to be the same for everybody else. Now, we're going to go over some examples, and you can easily add to these examples, or you can take away from these examples, but these are ones we thought of that would kind of hit a majority of you and what you guys are thinking when you're losing these last 10 pounds. So, like, it could be a CrossFit athlete who's simply looking to get a little bit better at gymnastics, who's maybe looking to get a little bit better at, and more efficient at movements that they've always struggled with. And, you know, anything you do CrossFit-wise, for the most part, obviously there's an argument for lifting weight, but we'll leave that out. If you lose more weight, you're probably going to be more efficient at that movement.
Yeah, you'll probably be better. Other than, yeah, more mass, exactly. Moves more mass, that's
for
an
sure.
Argument, but like that's not what we're talking about
no.
At all.
There could be an argument made where if you do get too lean or you get into this idea of almost like a body dysmorphia, you probably are going to lose a lot of strength and you may not make it up then. But for the most part, if you're leaner to an extent, you're probably going to be better overall.
Too lean's a thing,
yeah,
for sure.
I would agree.
Too fat's a thing.
Yes.
In CrossFit, I mean, just speaking, you want that middle ground there, but the leaner side of it is best bet.
Yes, so that's for a CrossFit athlete. Now for like a bodybuilder or an IFBB pro, who we're learning more about, I'd say. We don't know everything about it, so we've been learning a lot about that sport, and it's tough, but the last 10 pounds for those people is like going from high single digits to mid single digit body fat. You're going from 9% to 5% or 8% to 5%, whatever that 10 pounds looks for you. And we're talking about the most competitive at the top of your field, completely different, but all of the top five we have made up are gonna apply to you. It's gonna apply to everybody.
And the last 10 pounds for 99% of the people, honestly, that we're gonna talk about today, it's gonna apply to everyone, is simply to look better naked. Okay, we talk about this a lot, especially at OC3. Mm-hmm. I mean, dude, that's the goal. You wanna just look better naked. You wanna get out of the shower and look in the mirror and be like, yeah, I like that person there. That's a sexy looking person.
I look good.
I look good. Hey, everyone, come to see how good I look.
I look good. I mean, really good.
Hey, everyone, come and see how good I look.
So getting into the top five, what we're going to start with is the fifth reason why you're not losing those last 10 pounds. The fifth reason, and it's going to go down to what we think is the most important one, is you're simply snacking.
I am snacking. Cheetos, Pringles, ramen, French fries, chicken, nuggets, ice cream, sandwich. What am I craving? What am I craving? I am snacking.
You are snacking too much. You are, I call it grazing. You are grazing through your kitchen and your cupboards at night, and you simply do not realize how many calories you're actually ingesting, or, as Joe would like to say, at work.
Oh yeah, I'm guilty of that. All the time, physical therapists get their food from their patients, stuff like that. They'll bring in cookies, they'll bring in cake, they'll bring in, hey, I made you this homemade whatever, such and such. You gotta try it. It's so hard to not try it. Are you kidding me? This looks fantastic. And it is freaking difficult. I'm guilty of it as anyone else. At home, at work, I mean, it's tough to not eat that stuff.
And they're almost all, have you ever been placed in front of you in the rec room or wherever you guys go have these snacks and treats, a low calorie, high dense food. No, they're always high calorie, low always dense. Let's calorie. Just be honest, every single time. If you were to count it and measure it and actually weigh it, you would be shocked at how many extra calories you are eating a day by simply snacking. Some of you may not want to know, but it's true. That's probably keeping those last 10 pounds on you versus keeping them off you.
I think even if you went like 2 weeks of only eating breakfast, lunch, maybe a snack, and dinner, like, I think you could lose it, like,
you could.
Quickly. You know what you I'm could. Saying? Depending on who you are and where you're at in your life. But, like, those calories are really, really important. The snacking, grazing calories. And I'm guilty of it, man. I'll be honest with you. That's tough to not do.
It's very hard. So if you're one of these people, number one, stop snacking too much. And number two, if it's not possible, because I do snack a lot as well, find lower calorie foods that you can keep around that you can snack on throughout the day and be all right. And one of my big ones is like jerky sticks is one thing I have to keep around, low calorie, a little bit of protein, and rice cakes. Those are a little bit higher dense foods for lower calories that are easy to snack on and easy to grab throughout the day. So those are my two that I usually go to.
Both of those are good. Also low calories, just a piece of ice. Just kidding.
Yeah, the piece of ice has zero calories, so that's actually great. Crunch that shit up and put it in a protein shake and make it even more filling.
Number four on the list, we're working our way down, is that drinking your calories, especially on the weekend. You know, drinking stuff like this, I don't know if it has the caloric content on here.
I think it's like 130 calories.
I would say most beers, a good general reference, is between like 100 and 150 calories. If you're having like an IPA, it's probably more. Even like Gatorade, stuff like that. Like that added sugar, I mean, that stuff just adds up. Drink water throughout the course of the day. I mean, don't go home and slam two glasses of wine, two beers, and a shot of whiskey. I mean, that's the calories are just going to add up exponentially.
Even in a shot, there's over 100 calories in most shots. It's insane that how quickly they add up to your day.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, you think about it. Seriously, let's have just one drink every single night. That's an extra 100 calories a day, you know, for 5 days.
700
and
calories.
That, yeah, it was seven.
Not even including the weekends where you're probably going to drink more.
That's what I'm saying. If you drink you're going to have more. I mean, come on. There's thousands of calories a week that you're just leaving out there. I mean, that's a ton.
Yeah, and it's a good point. If you take away your midnight snack beer or whatever, your later night snack beer before you go to bed, that's at least getting 500 calories to maybe 750 calories back a week,
right?
That maybe you could put it on the weekend, or you could just stop drinking it. And, you know, that's going to add up over time. 3,500, you know, calories in a gram of fat or in a pound of fat. Well, Diet Pop, that's a good thing to drink. Find something you like that maybe is even has a little carbonation in it. I like Fresca. I drink probably 3 Frescas a night because I like it, I enjoy it, and it has 0 calories. So it's not the end of the world if you drink some Diet Pop and you go that, if you don't like Diet Pop, drink that LaCroix stuff that tastes like absolute
God,
shit.
Don't drink that. Don't drink
people do drink it. I don't know why they drink it when they have actually good options out there, but it is a drink people do drink.
You know what I actually got into? My buddy turned me on to. It's called Bubbler or something like that. I'll post a little picture of it, but it's 5 calories. It's actually freaking delicious.
Is it really?
Yeah, there's like blueberry one or whatever. I'll have to get you one.
The number third, the number third.
Number third.
That was dumb. The third one on the list is going to be eating too many high-calorie, low-dense foods. That's right. So I have a client at the gym. He eats out pretty much most of his meals. And the thing is, he doesn't realize how many extra calories he's ingesting. You are eating so many, you're eating so little density of food that it's not filling you up. So then you've got to go back and eat more. Or you're starving by the end of the night and you take home and you eat all your calories in one sitting at night. You don't realize how easy it is to eat so many fucking calories in one sitting. So people are like, oh, I'm going to save on my calories. No, you're not, because you're going to go overboard and eat way too much. So you cannot allow yourself to get more hungry. I see a lot of people say that where they're like, oh, we'll put off more calories and save them for the end. No, you're not going to save them. You're better off eating your normal diet. And I think eating a little bit more higher dense foods, lower calorie before you go out. So hopefully then when you do eat them, you get so full that you literally don't want to eat anymore.
You got to smash a pound of broccoli before you start to eat your food.
Or that
you
got to do great. Something. A huge salad, something
huge salad
would be awesome.
To just start to get your stomach used to like,
yes.
Okay, I think I'm going to start getting full soon before you smash the, you know, massive double burger or whatever it is. Yes. Like, you got to do something.
And we're not sitting here saying we don't eat that stuff or we don't go out and have a good time. We literally just had a conversation about how drunk we both got this weekend and how much bad food we ate.
It was terrible.
We're not saying that. We're saying that you can get full throughout the day. Don't skip meals. Oh, I haven't eaten anything today. You are going to make that up by so quickly by adding in these higher calorie, low dense foods. It's that simple. It's too easy to eat it. I mean, like you said when we were talking, these big cookies that you're...
Crumble cookies.
Realistically, take a guess. How many calories do you think was in one crumble cookie?
Dude, I probably ate 9 of them. It was probably 1,000 calories each.
So he thinks that he ate 9 and there were 1,000 calories each.
Yeah.
And because you know why he ate more? Because they're not filling. You can keep eating them.
And I was drunk.
And he was drunk. Yep. Which doesn't help either, but... If you stop and you're super full, it's gonna help you overall.
Number two, your calorie equation that you think that you're eating and that you're burning is probably wrong. Actually, it is wrong, I guarantee it. You are not weighing your food appropriately, and even if you are weighing your food, you're doing it wrong, for sure. The scale that you're probably using might be a little bit off. The actual measuring tool is probably off, potentially up to 20 to 30%, some studies have found. So that's probably wrong. And then you're like, yeah, I worked out for like an hour today, so I probably burned like 2,000 calories. Come on. No, you didn't. You probably burned 400 maybe.
Yeah.
You know, so the equation that is going on in your head, it has to be actually written down on paper and measured and weighed appropriately. Otherwise, it's wrong.
And the people rely, and I love that point, because people rely too much on the equation too. You also, the best equation is to get on the scale, you know, and take an average of it pretty much every day at the same time and get off the scale. I think I ate a cookie and it was about 300 calories. Well, no, that cookie was more about 800 calories. And doesn't Panera Bread have a little small, a cookie that's like 900 calories? Fact check us on that one. Go figure it out. But I mean, I don't even know what they're called. But seriously, you eat a cookie on top of your meal.
Right.
That's 900. So it's double what a normal meal is, about 500-ish calories on your dessert. Like, you just don't realize how bad your calorie equation is.
And then most people would probably be like, well, it's just a cookie. I'm not even going to track it anyways.
Exactly
right. You just missed 900 calories. Yeah. You know, I mean, that's huge.
That's insane. And you do it 3 times a week. So you're adding in 3,000 extra calories on just your cookie desserts throughout the week. But then you're starving yourself and you eat it all on the weekend, so it's fine.
Yeah, good luck losing that weight, buddy.
It just doesn't make any sense. Your calorie equation has got to be better. Use a scale. That's probably the first thing.
Yep.
Underestimate how many calories you're actually burning. So don't overestimate anything. If the monitor says you burned 500 calories, you probably burned more like 300 calories or 400 calories. Those things are so far off. If your fitness tracker, your little watch thing here, tells you got this many steps and you burned this many calories, it's probably off. And number two, you probably shouldn't be thinking you can eat those calories.
Yeah, you need to be in the negative there. Yes. You lose a couple pounds here and there. You can't be like, well, I did this, so then I can equal that. No, because you're going to just keep gaining weight.
Exactly right. Your movement is what is putting you in that deficit. Why don't you just go out for an experiment just to end this? Why don't you just go out for one experiment, eat 1,000 calories. So go get yourself one of them Panera Bread cookies and huddle up next to it, eat it in 3 fucking bites. And then why don't you go outside and try to burn it off? And tell us how long it takes for your watch to say you burned 1,000 calories. I bet you it takes over 90 minutes for most people. You know, if you're quick and you can really move, you can do it in about an hour. But that's someone who's pretty goddamn fit and they're moving at a nice clip.
Not most people.
And it's not most people. It's probably not you. So just go ahead and do that experiment one time. Eat something that's super low density, super high calorie, and go ahead and try to go burn it off.
And then leave us some comments on what you actually did.
Let us know how long it took.
How long did it take?
Finally, probably the quickest one and the most important one is, how do you lose those last 10 pounds? You don't. It's a myth. Okay, if you're an IFBB pro and you're like, I need to get super shredded, I'm going to get, okay, obviously you can. If it's someone on the gymnastics rig and they wanted to get, for a CrossFit competition, they wanted to get 10 pull-ups and they get 10 pull-ups and they lost the 10 pounds, as soon as they get 10 pull-ups, what do they then want to do?
You're either A, going to gain that weight back, or B, you want to do 12 pull-ups, so now you got to lose more weight.
You want to do 12 pull-ups, and then you want to do a fucking bar muscle-up, so then you got to lose 5 more pounds, and then guess what you want to do? Now you got to get stronger, now you've got to start getting your upper back a little bit stronger, get your hips to the bar, so you got to start learning more form.
Nothing to do with losing weight, but yes, agreed 100%.
As soon as you look in the mirror, you're going to want to lose more.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is.
Everyone's always, I don't want to say disgusted, but for lack of a better word, they look in the mirror and they're like, ugh, my butt's too big. Ugh, my hips are too big. Ugh, I don't see any of my abs anymore. Mm-hmm. You want to lose that weight. Even though you just lost 10 pounds, the last 10 pounds, well, now you got 10 more to lose.
I mean, how many times have you heard of the last 10 pounds, if people tell you the last 10 pounds? It's every day. Everybody's always on the last 10 pounds, but that's why they quit. Stop saying the last 10 pounds. You're not going to lose them. It's that simple. You're not going to. Stop fucking around with it. Here's what you do, is be okay with the things you can do and you want to do in your life. The way you want to perform, the way you want to feel energy-wise, the things you want to do on the weekend. If you can do all that, and then you can go in front of the mirror and be like, damn, I look pretty goddamn good.
That's a win right there.
That's all you got to do.
That's what you got to do.
You ain't got to play tricks on your mind saying you're going to lose the last 10 pounds. You're not going to lose the last 10 pounds. And even if you do and you get to the point where you lose the last 10 pounds, IFBB pro style, you feel like total garbage.
Yeah.
You feel terrible. You're not going to be able to sustain it, and you're going to end up gaining 20 pounds back. And then guess what? You're back to your last 10 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
It's the way it is.
Exactly.
We're being honest with you. I'm trying to help you.
So just a recap, guys, to finish it off, the number 5 going down to 1 is snacking. You are snacking and grazing too often. You need to cut that out if you're trying to lose those last 10 pounds. Number 4 is drinking your calories. You got to cut that out. You're drinking your calories and wasting those away. You need those calories for the weekend. Number 3 is you're eating too many high calorie, low density food. You need more broccoli in your life and salad in your life to get rid of that. Number 2 on the list here is calorie equation is wrong. Actually write it down. You got to get that figured out to actually burn the calories compared to what you're actually taking in. Number 1 is it's a myth. We talked about that. You're never going to be able to lose the last 10 pounds because the last 10 pounds never really exists. One of the things that we did talk about here, Colin and I, just a little bit ago, is moving. Move more should be on there. We're huge proponents of actually moving more in general. Mm-hmm. We don't think that it's on this list because the difference between you just not eating a donut or you burning those 500, 600, 700 calories that's in that donut,
yeah,
is huge. If you have all day long, like our Marcus Filler video, to move all day long, then yeah, you can absolutely do that and you don't have to worry about the calories and you don't have to, you know, you have to count it that way or whatever else. But if you're a normal person, just don't eat those calories, don't drink those calories, don't graze. Just all the things that we talked about earlier is gonna be your best benefit.
What Joe and I are gonna do and what we're getting to is at the end of this summer, we're going to do a video and just show you how difficult it is to burn off a bunch of calories versus eating a bunch of calories. So we're gonna do, I don't know if we're gonna do the 10,000, 10,000, because that looks terrible in 24 hours, which is where you have to burn 10,000 calories and then you consume 10,000 calories
in 24 hours,
ridiculously hard. So we're going to try something like that just to show you how difficult it is. And there's other videos on it right now on YouTube. Go watch those videos. They are super interesting, and
they're
these
cool.
YouTubers do a great job. So look them up. Joe and I might tackle that one later on in the summer, but that'll show you why we think these calorie equations are so important.
All right, guys, what is in your top 5? What do you think is the most important things about losing those last 10 pounds? If you guys have magically achieved the losing of the last 10 pounds, you got to let us know. You got to drop a comment below. Like this video, share it, subscribe to the channel if you have not thus far. Get this content out. Thanks for tuning in.
Peace.
Oh, need the light on.
We're light.
The circle.
I was like, we look a little dark. You know, and you know what? Did we turn the mic?
Yeah, I turned it on.
Oh, fuck. Oh, God.
Let me just check just to make sure. But I'm pretty sure it turned it on.
Yep, that fucker's turned on.
Dude, that's every time.
We suck at YouTube, but we're figuring it out.
I killed this spider the other day with a saw gun. Freaking massive. And it freaking died. Curled up dead.
Damn it!
Dude, I gained 13 pounds in Park City.
Dude.
4 days.
High calorie, low dense. Dude, it doesn't make sense in my head either. I gotta say it like before I say it.
I'm so fucked up.